Hey guys, check it out. GameKey here. We got our lovely chair, finally, that you guys raised money for. Thank you so much, guys. It's not a DX Racer, but guys, it's a heavy-duty executive office chair that I used the money we raised to get. So this has to be better than, you know, broken fold-out chairs and such. So let's do this, guys. We're going to unbox it and put together right here with you. Don't mind the background noise. Wife's watching, you know, TV and whatnot, and she's like right over there, just off camera in this area. So yeah, all right, let's unbox her. Oh, I won't. Oh, come on. There we go. That heavy-duty tinsel, guys. That heavy-duty tinsel. There we go. And obviously the box looks like it goes like this. Ugh. What is underneath of it? Oh, it's the straps. Let me go get a knife. Oh, remember, kids, don't play with knives. Okay, this is like some heavy-duty tape here. Oh man. Dude, really? Oh damn. We really do gotta put it all together, guys. Look at that. Alright, we got our directions here. We're gonna put it together, folks. Let's get her done. Attention, please contact us first for part replacement claims or questions. Ooh. We got a little phone number part supplier thing. All right, let's open this box though. Cardboard! I found the headrest. Oh, it's attached to a lot of other stuff. Oh. Jeez, that's a heavy little box. Nails. I'm gonna guess these are screws and parts. Yeah, that sounds about right. The headrest. I feel so much better already. Need it. I might want this giant poster. My hair is tickling my beard. Oh no! Alright, now we have the big parts. Wow. Oh no. Some stuff went flying. What was it? Okay, it's some cardboard. Oh, it really is cardboard. Okay, I don't need it. All right, here we go. Ooh, that's the back of the chair right there. Wow. This is like an 80-pound chair, man. Holy crap. And the fun part, the legs. Or a steering wheel. Or the non-finished rim to a tire. Let's see how shiny it is. Ooh! wants to play with my dongle! Ew. But no, seriously. We need to undo all of this. Ooh. It's like all chromed out. I like this. Come on, before I whack myself in the face with it. You know? Sometimes putting a chair together isn't that easy, folks. Put that there. And what might you be? Are you the chair thingamabobber? Ah, you're the lever. We're unboxing the chair and getting ready to put it together, folks. Uh-oh, do I need this? No, it's styrofoam. I can almost get lost in this box, guys. Oh, no! Help me! No! Oh. This. I can do this part right now without instructions. I think. I don't think I need it. Instructions for this part. Look. Ta-da! We're going to toss the box to the side for now. Let's see. Step one. As mentioned earlier, this is carefully move all parts from the chair carton. Keep original packing packaging materials. Great. Is this in case we break the chair? I mean, seriously, guys. I don't want to break this one. Not again. So, let's unpack everything. There we go. Our nice leather seat. And I'm not thrilled with leather. It tends to make me sweat a lot. But that's okay. Well, that's what I mean. I can put like one of these little cushion seats down. Okay. We still gotta undo the box with all the crazy tools in it. This just slides right in. That's what she said. All right. Let's put all our cardboard away.
I want to be a wheelchair.
That's what the fold-up chair is, guys. It wants to be a real chair. When I grow up, I want to be a real chair! Aww! Like Gingy. Clean up the big mess. Remember, folks, feel free to ask me where I got it. I'll be posting the link in the description down below. All right, let's undo this seat. It seems to have instructions in it. That ain't good. No, I don't want more instructions. I don't. One page is enough.
Well, maybe
oh, it's a parts list. We don't need that. We don't need a parts list. We won't need it until we end up with extra parts or parts we don't have.
Okay.
That's when we'll need the parts list.
Okay.
to a good chair.
The butt
to a good chair. Yep. Okay. The ass end. That's what I'll say. The ass end to a good chair. That's okay. They can sleep later.
You want them down here?
No. Okay. What? I'm not allowed to make a video the way I want? Jeez, guys. You see this game, Mom? Already just saying, fuck it! Don't make your video!
Nope.
Now what am I going to do?
Make it anyways.
I'm going to beat people with this. That's what I'm going to do. They'll get all chromed out face first. Alright, let's open up that fine, fine box of parts. I'm kind of afraid to. Ooh, it's a heavy box, too. It's heavy. This box, guys, is heavy. Woo! Talk about being busy. I got this thing. Ugh. Get out of the packaging. Get. Hey, it's an arm. Sweet. Don't worry, we have two of them. You know, you can't have a chair without two armrests. At least a good one. Well, GameKey, what are you talking about? My DX Racer didn't come with armrests. So what are you saying, it's not a real chair? No, I'm saying everyone is selective. I have to have armrests. I'm comfortable that way. Why? Because when I'm done streaming, the camera's off. I can just sit back and relax, and dream that this chair is already put together for me. Yes. I don't want to do any work. Well, sometimes when you buy things, some assembly is required. Let's just hope batteries aren't required.
That would suck.
Wow. Now, this is a slender box. It's heavy. I hope our chair doesn't come with, chair toy. Y'all know what I'm talking about. We don't want lady mature dildos. Ew! It's round! It's oh my god, what is this? We don't want this!
It looks like one too.
See? Even the wife wants it. No! You can't have it.
I said it looks like
it goes to our chair.
I said it looks like one.
It's not a lady toy.
It is.
Yes, we're putting dildos in our chairs now. I guess that's how they can support 350 pounds. Because sometimes some men really do make the sacrifice. I'm just saying, guys, when you're out there with your buddy and you're taking one for the team, you know, it happens. It happens. And then that guy is not happy because he lost it. All right, we got some Allen wrenches, some screw caps for all of these bolts. We got short, medium, and long hex bolts. That is just fine here. Some of the cool stuff I do like already. This chair is already going to be easy. We just have to physically do it. Here's those little sleeve thingies. Yep, them little sleeve covers. Okay, cool. We got the Leaning Tower of Plastic thingies, and it just goes, cup game. We're going to play a game of cups. Coach, I don't want to take mine out when I go off the field. Then don't wear one. But then Tommy's going to hit me in the groin. Well, then stop playing the cup game. Okay, we're almost there. Let's see. Step two. Carefully open, do not tear, and remove chair parts from individual packaging. We did that. Do not tear bags. I did that. Damn it. Three, check all chair parts from the parts list on the assembly instructions for missing or damaged parts. I don't want to go to the website. I just want to start building. Okay. If you never assembled a chair carefully, repack all chair components into carton. Really? Really? Okay, let's do this. If you assembled the chair carefully... Wait, I have to go online for the instructions. Are you kidding me? They really make it somewhat annoying at times. Interesting. Okay, so... Oh, there's our doodle. We got it. Found it. Let's see. I should have instructions here. Like, this can't be it. Oh. Okay, so I'm gonna put this together myself. Okay, let's wing it, guys, for the first time. I don't even want to do that. I already know where this goes. In the top of the seat, in the top of the backrest, which is not this bad boy. Front. Oh, look at that. Okay. So... Oh, got it. Okay, I know what I'm doing. That's the front. So this part goes here. Then we have this right here. Seat plate, seat cushion. Wait, am I supposed to have a big plate on the back of this? I don't think I'm supposed to. Damn. This thing's gonna be like... Oh! Like this. Okay. Making sense now. Here we go. Oops. Oops. Here's an easy part. Yeah! We got one!
One!
Is that how this goes? I feel like that's not it. I'm looking at the directions, guys. Don't worry. It just sucks when you're trying to put it together. And they're like, I'll just call customer service because we don't pack real instructions here. Sucks a little bit. There's gotta be something I'm missing. That's where these arms go. Man, this seat is literally heavy duty, guys. It's ridiculous. So, they're not kidding. They're not kidding. Okay, what did I do with the, oh, right here. Right in front of me. There really is no directions. Ow. I have to get off of my legs. Killing me here. Killing me, Smalls. You're killing me. For these. For these. Some screw caps. Which ones, though? Hmm? Which ones? Which ones get the screw caps? I don't know. There's like 12, 16, 14. I can't count screws here. And there's only four caps. They gotta go somewhere. I should probably be streaming this. Even better. We're making a YouTube video that'll last forever! Alright. Those. This. Small, medium, large. I guess that's these long ones right here. I'm going to guess we have spares for any given day. Ow, I just cut myself a little bit. I've got so many Allen wrenches, but guys, I think I have like one full toolbox full of these already, from every little thing that you'd ever have to put together. Sad part is, they don't give you a size, so I just have what they consider a small, which is probably an 8mm. It's kind of crazy. Let's see. Will this one get all the way down in there? Okay, that works. Yeah. Or maybe it's these. Maybe not. I still don't understand why I have some serious screws. Like, ridiculous screws, guys. I'm not kidding. Let's see. These medium-sized ones. They're the same. Because I'm going to try one. I'm gonna guess that's where these long ones go. Nope, never mind. They don't go all the way in. These long screws are not threaded all the way through, so we can't use them. We gotta take out this other one. We kind of screwed up here. We took a medium screw and put it on this flimsy part. We don't need it here. We need it to hold the back end of our chair here, and they give us a plate. So we kind of need a little back end help. I think my chair is flaking. Hilarious. All right, this will just take a moment. Almost there, guys. We've got like 8 screws and some parts. Haha, yeah! Oh, come on. There we go. So, if you guys have anything that you want to do with the time and fill the space, let me know. Maybe we can add some goofy-ass music to this. You know, cut out some mute some sections. Whatever, I'm open to anything to make this video a little more interesting. Because I know some folks are like, hell no, we don't want to see an unboxing and this guy putting it together and, you know, just a big guy putting a little chair together. Like, hey, you know, all for the sake of gaming. All for the sake of video games, folks. That's what I do. And then, to make matters worse, why not help St. Jude? Why not help Operation Supply Drop? Why not help stack-up.org? These are all great organizations that I also work with to support. Why don't you guys check them out? They'll be in the descriptions down below. We definitely raise money for St. Jude Live, Operation Supply Drop, and I really want to help stack-up.org as well. So take the time, as you already are doing if you've gotten it to this point, to check those links down below as you wait some more for us putting this chair together. However, stick around, guys. We will have some prizes potentially for, you know, the next week or two. We've got some random Steam keys to do some giveaways with, guys. I have no clue what they are, but the winners, the lucky winners, you'll have to send me your email address, my friends. So we need up to the 100th subscriber, whoever that turns out to be, and then the 150th subscriber to the channel. You guys are going to be getting prizes. Definitely get in on the fun. All right. There's this. Where's our cup game? It's over here. I think I'm supposed to put it on this. Oh, it's all greased up. Oh, God. Our dildo, it's greased. Oh, no. Where's that leather go? Where does that piece go? I'm actually curious. So, throwing me for a loop here. I don't know what this little leather piece goes to. most annoying thing ever. Assuming it all goes together. I declare thumb war.
You're crazy.
I'll put that right there.
I found some pretty good, decent price clothes at Walmart.
Yeah.
They got a whole bunch of clearances, like tops for $5, pants for $5. It's a pretty good deal.
All right. Put it on just like that. Love you too.
Are you doing okay over there?
I think so.
You're not having a hard
time? I think this is how it goes. I could very well be wrong, guys. I could very well be wrong. Real soon. Alright. Now, we put on the back. The meat of this chair. Not only is it going to support our great rump, our rear, our teaster, or whatever you want to call it, it is going to support it.
Booty.
Let's get these screws in. Oh my god. Wow. My legs are like, nope. I don't like this. And I'm thinking I don't like it either. Woo! You guys got me sweating over here. I feel like I'm working. My legs and everything are asleep. Woo! Not cool! So, this kind of reminds me of the time when I was younger, real young, with my father. And he wanted me to work on the car with him. I said, nah, you know, let me go play. I want to hang out with my friends. Well, I did all that stuff. Had a great time. Well, these are the moments where my father would get with me and tell me stories. Now I get to share that, a story or two with you guys. So, growing up for me, it wasn't all, you know, video games and computers and stuff like that. I hope you guys do realize, you know, 10, 15 years ago, everything was really, really different. Essentially, you know, you had the 8-bit NES, the Sega, the Super Nintendo. So what? So did a lot of other kids. Hell, I remember the coolest chick in the neighborhood had Sega Channel. My family didn't believe in video games. You're never gonna go anywhere playing video games. Yeah, I know, Mom, I know. But guess what? I play video games for a living now. I can make fun of it now because I made fun of it a lot then. And Mom was awesome. Mom was really cool. My dad, he also gets it. My father finally gets it now, guys. He understands what Twitch is a little bit. He understands what I do, but he doesn't really get it. I mean, it's just one of those things. But what I liked best about my time with my father, we would go fishing and camping and all that cool stuff that fathers do. Well, he wasn't just the average dad. I remember sitting in his truck. I was probably about 9, 9 and a half. And I freaked out. It was the middle of the night. We were out camping. And there's a heat storm. I thought the lightning was going to get me, guys. I really did. But my dad made it like fireworks. He said it was the coolest thing that I'd ever get to see. And he was right. Watching a lightning storm is probably one of those cool things that you can spend time with your family and not get hurt, guys, unless lightning strikes your house. And then I feel for you folks, because that's just not cool. But that was like the thing to do as a kid. You'd sit back and you'd watch your neighborhood. You'd sit on your, you know, your enclosed porch, or you know, your porch that had a little roof over it. And you'd get together and you'd sit in your chairs and just watch the crazy storm happening out in the neighborhood. And it was awesome. It was really cool. That was the coolest, two of the coolest moments I've ever had with a storm where I live. 5 years ago, shit. I'll tell you the most recent one, and then the older one from when I was 6. Okay, the new one, the most recent one. Basically, I was living with my brother at the time. It's 2010. I finally come home from active duty and everything. I'm chilling. I'm enjoying the money I got at the time. I was an idiot. I spent $11,000 in 3 months. But I learned my lesson, guys, as a young 20-something-year-old idiot who didn't have kids, who didn't have a woman who was crazy about him. Wasn't crazy about a woman. That was number 3. And basically, I'm with my best friend, and he's helping me set up a particle board for my window. It's storming like crazy and everything. Little do I know that when I popped my head up over the particle board, because we hadn't got it up yet, we had just looked out the front yard and saw this huge, huge beam of lightning. It was essentially as big as the little shed that was right behind our neighbor's house in this huge field. And you couldn't see the shed for just a brief moment. That was how big this lightning looked. It was huge. It was so cool because it was terrifying. It was loud. It shook the house. But what was really cool about it, it was maybe about 30 feet from the front porch. And I was looking out my window of the front from the attic. It was a sight to behold, guys. Crazy, but it was a sight to behold. I say that because after that, I tried to stay out of the rain for like the next month and a half. I was terrified of, you know, lightning striking twice. And, you know, you crack the jokes and everything. And, well, it can happen. It's a scary thing. You know, folks go out golfing, bam, head split open. Or, you know, one guy just His tongue piercing's gone. His nipple rings, his nipples are burnt. And his rings are just zap. They're gone off their body. You know, something crazy. And that is what made it so scary, because I'm like 22, 23 years old. You know, this is, what, 2010? So go back. I'm 22. You know, I just turned 22. And I'm like, oh my God, this is crazy shit. Well, what are you going to do? Oh, you're going to order?
I'm getting Mamarosas.
Oh, okay.
What do you want?
If you're just doing that, then I'll just take a 2 gyros. That's it.
Just 2 gyros?
Yeah. I'm just not crazy hungry. There we go. Yeah. Okay. Let's cinch it down. I think I'm set. I think. We never know. Ah. So that's what those other 4 screws are for. Okay. Let's put this bad boy on the ground. Or on its side. Because we're going to put them arm bars on. Give him an arm bar. But yeah, guys, that's what I did in my neighborhood. That was the fun of the neighborhood back then. Now the much, much younger story. I'm 6 years old. Well, what was really cool about that time, huge rainstorm is just blowing the neighborhood all over the place. What happened? I was almost on a corner street. There was like 3 houses over, and then you had a corner that went down one way and back up the hill. So you had a little tuck of like 5 or 6 houses down on the dead end there, and then you had the hill. Well, you turn the corner, go up the hill, a tree fell. Okay, we didn't think nothing of it. This is supposed to be the craziest rainstorm of, you know, like the past 10 or 15 years. Well, something you'll never have today. Never will have it, because the neighborhood sucks. Communities suck today. It's all about, you know, what do they got? Who's got better? How can I one-up this guy? How can I stop that guy from getting this? And, you know, how can I steal from the neighbor across the way? It's all that craziness. The neighborhood came together to move, like, trees. Trees had fallen in the road. And, like, 8 or 9 neighborhood, like, guys, big guys, and older teenagers came together and, like, hoisted this tree up and moved it out of the way. Why? We had traffic on both ends trapped behind a bunch of trees. So in order to keep traffic going, we had to move them to, like, the sidewalk. And the city came out and tore them up, you know, when the storm had finished. But that sense of community, that help, you'll never have that kind today. Except unless, you know, you're in a middle class to high class neighborhood where everyone knows each other. You don't meet and greet anymore. You know, everyone's afraid of this, the guy next to them, to their left and to their right. It sucks. And I think we need to come together as a community and stop that shit. That's just me, though. Let's see.
That's definitely just you.
Huh?
I said that's definitely just you. People like that aren't, you know,
comfortable. Yeah, yeah.
Comfortable.
Here we go. Let's see. Oh dear. I think I screwed up, but I could very well be wrong. Okay. Oh. Do we have four of these, man? Damn. Shit! I screwed up! Let's come back over here. We're gonna take out two of these long ones. Just two. And substitute them with medium. Medium screws, guys. Medium.
Did you do what I think you did? I played the fifth tequila. Well, you three probably want to be alone.
Ah, okay. Here we go.
I knew it wouldn't work for
him. I have to say, this whole matter stupid thing really starts to get to me. Sometimes I'm having trouble sleeping.
Me too. Are you getting acid reflux?
We're almost done though, guys. We're almost done. All we have to do is attach the arms, and away we go with gaming. But seriously, if you guys have any childhood stories that you want to share that you thought were awesome for when you were growing up, let me know. Throw them in the comment section down below, and let's have a time of it, guys. Hell, if you want to make a YouTube video of telling us some of your greatest stories from when you were a kid, from your parents, your grandparents, what have you, feel free to do so. You know, make a YouTube video. Make not a Skype call, but, put it on Imgur or something else, you know. Something where we can all get together and see it. And put it in the comments section down below, guys. You know, besides video games, I could talk to you guys about streaming, video games, what I do all day, my past jobs, my work history. I could talk to you guys all day about that stuff. And it's... I have no problem with it. I've got no problem with it. Why? It can be boring, but it's fun. Ow! Would you turn it up because I'm talking?
Sorry.
Really? I can't do... See, I can't do a video, guys. Damn. She's just like, I'm going to turn it up to 30 because you're talking so loud for a YouTube video. Game Mom doesn't like it when we do videos because we talk too loud. I stream too loud. And all sorts of craziness. That's a cool car.
We should do that when we get married.
They're too big.
I know.
Who's getting married? Kimmy?
No, Kimmy and that Mexican dude.
Oh, okay.
Orlando or whatever.
That's cool. Mm-hmm. You know, married. I'm over here, just wife's watching Fuller House. I figured I'd ask. I gotta ask questions. This shit's like from forever ago, and now they're all grown up. So many adult jokes in the show, though. So many adult jokes. man. See, this is what I get for putting too tight. We're almost done. We two screws here, four for the arms, and we're good to go. Oh my goodness. Let's see. What's a good story about doing dumb shit? Well, this one time while I was in the Marine Corps, you know, I was told to fill a HESCO barrier. If you guys don't know what a HESCO barrier, it's a, quite literally, the it's a cool invention. But they have them all over Iraq and on bases and stuff. And essentially it's a giant barrier made out of the dirt you fill it with and like steel mesh. You know, it's like a giant square and you fill up this sack full of dirt. And the steel's just like another reinforcement. Well, I remember getting in trouble and we had to go fill these things. Well, not only did we have to fill them, we had to unfill them first. I was like, really? You're kidding me, right? Nope, you're gonna unfill them. Okay, whatever you say, Gunny. And so, we literally would just throw rocks at traffic all day. Sucks a little bit. A lot of it. Come on. Come on. I let go of me. That's like what I feel like this screw is saying. Let go. At worst, I'll have to go buy screws. Which is fine. I can do that. Some good old classic movies. Anything with Arnold Schwarzenegger in it. So you got Terminator movies. Then you have Kindergarten Cop. You have Eraser. Eraser was good. Eraser was a good movie. Let's see. Commando? If you guys believe it or not, Contra on the NES, actually, you know, was it Nintendo? I think that's who made it, or maybe it was Konami, Capcom, one of them. Anyway, they were sued for making, by Arnold Schwarzenegger and Sylvester Stallone for a likeness, guys. You can Google it, guys. Contra, likeness to Commando and Rambo. It's pretty hilarious. Which, why not? They were some of the coolest, most badass folks on the planet. I mean, yeah, you know, so what? We had Bruce Willis over there with his Die Hard series. Trilogy, right? And Lethal, and Mel Gibson with Lethal Weapon. Nobody was awesome like Sylvester Stallone in Rambo. And nobody was like Arnold Schwarzenegger in any soldier movie. Especially Commando. That's where they fought a predator, yeah?
Yep.
I think that's what they did.
Yep.
But it was a whole troop of soldiers. And Arnold Schwarzenegger was the one badass who got away. Good movie. I definitely recommend anything I have said, even the Bruce Willis Die Hard movies. If you guys are action movie fans, definitely check those movies out. Really worth it. Screw. There it is. Nope, fall. Now let's see, any movie recommendations, definitely drop them in the comments section down below. I did like the Rocky movies. I got the whole box set because I like the Rocky movies. And the fight with the Russian was by far one of the coolest fights in Rocky.
I love that one.
I don't care about the last one. It's like Floyd Mayweather versus Rocky Balboa. You know what I mean? It's just like, eh. That's what that last movie with Sylvester Stallone out of the Rocky series made me feel like. Like I was supposed to root for, you know, Holyfield or Mayweather, or whoever the fuck it is now. I believe it's Mayweather. But still. Come on. Come on. Okay. I think I stripped a screw, guys. Crap. I digress. Let's see, we talked about storms and fatherly moments, community. Let's talk about some of our favorite video games. I mean, this is a video game channel after all. And I can honestly say, 8-bit Nintendo.
No.
Castlevania series. Zelda. Way, did I break it? No way, man. Fuck. It's just one screw.
I know where we have the real
see. No. Chair's getting me. Yeah, that screw just isn't gonna cut it. That's terrible. One screw is messed up. We got a faulty screw here. Faulty. All right. Let's see. Another good one. I don't know if any of you have ever played it. It's a game called Crystallis. By far, one of the top games from my childhood. Really, really good. So worth. Put on the arms. Now we get excited, guys. Yay! 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. We're almost done, guys, and then the gaming continues. Bigger one. That's what she said. But seriously, if you guys have any really good memories besides the stuff we've shared here, let me know. Feel free to come by, stop by, and share those stories, because they make good for times like this. They really do. Come on. But no, seriously, I'm having a real tough time. Screws in there. At least. All All right. Love you too, babe. This is what it's all about, guys. Family. This stuff is always all about family. Because nothing is better than family. Nothing brings you closer together than family. These caps go on this one, go on this. Aha! Found out what the caps go to. These sides here, that's pretty darn nice. Yeah! Who's freaking awesome? This guy! There we go. Now we do the other side. And we're done! We're completely done. Holy cow. It's raining outside. It's supposed to snow here soon. Yeah. Come on. Oh, I hope I'm not scraping it. Probably not. I don't know. Interesting. Okay, here we go. We are almost done. We are almost done. I'm gonna have to force this one. That sucks. I'm gonna have to force this arm to fit. Come on. Is that it? Yep, there we go. Oh, I'm gonna have to force this big time. Not the greatest thing ever. Yeah, we got it now. Fine. finally, I got it to grip on. Jesus. Woo. One of these arms is not in the right place at the right time. Nope. Come here. All right, guys, there we go. Heck yeah. I made an awesome chair. Some assembly required. Besides getting me sweaty, this chair's ready to go. I feel better. Yeah, buddy.
Nice.
Make me so mad. Make me want to spit. Who spit my visor? Someone. Gotta love red versus blue, guys. It's a reference. It's in there. Get that on there. Got that on. Oh, we're not done. We got a headrest. We got a headrest, boys and girls. I still don't know what this piece was. I looked everywhere for something that I could put this to. There's nothing. Maybe it's just spare leather? Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. That is exactly what I'm thinking. Let's stand up. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my legs are, like, done from, like, sitting on them. And it's not even that I'm a big guy. They fell asleep. They fell a friggin' sleep. Ha-ha! Whoa! We got our lean on here. Jeez.
I hope you don't fall down.
Haha! Oh, this is nice. I feel like I put the end on wrong. I'm supposed to be able to lean back, not lean forward. It's quite literally the simple adjustment of turning the plate around that's on the bottom. But that's okay. It's like, it's not bad. I can do that tomorrow. But yes, we have our gaming chair. I'm not going to be doing a lot of leaning back anyway. Like, this feels comfortable for me. This feels great. I like this.
Hope you don't fall down.
This is a nice chair. I'll fix it tomorrow. I'll do that off stream, guys. All right, let me know what you guys think. This is the Walmart chair. It was $200. It is a Commodore 2 oversized leather chair with adjustable headrest, model number 60-5800T. It's all black. Chair's weight capacity is 350 pounds. I bought this thing so me and one of my kids, I'm not naming names, my son, basically will jump in my lap and we're going to be good. Yeah, success! Success!
Jeez, babe, you don't need to be extremely loud.
Well, I'm going to be loud because I'm happy. Chairmaster put together guy of the universe. Oh! I love you, babe. All right, guys. If you want to see me live in this chair, come over to our Twitch channel, twitch.tv/GAM3K3Y. The link is always down below. And welcome to the arcade, everyone. Uh-oh, I have a loose armrest. That's going to drive me nuts. Good night, folks.
And see you next time.